Hey guys, this is Stephanie and I am Stacks on Stacks on Stacks. Day 11 of the Spring Tuit Vlogathon. I hope you have enjoyed the first third of the month. And if this is something you think you want to do, I have linked all the prompts down below. You can do prompts that have passed. You can do the ones that are to come, and so you can put it on the same date as us. Whatever works for you, we just want you guys to get involved. So today's topic is books that I want to read, but they're not popular on BookTube. I really liked this topic. I feel like I have so many books on my shelves that I either like read the synopsis and I'm like, that sounds great, or a friend recommended to me like in real life, but I don't really see these books on BookTube. Now I know that BookTube tends to be a predominantly YA society, though not exclusively. So I'm a little surprised that a few of the series that I'm going to talk about are YA and I haven't really heard about them. Now maybe they were popular when they first came out and I just missed the boat, but I really haven't heard much about these. So if you guys have read any of the series I'm gonna talk about, I want you to tell me down below. It's great, you should read it, or please don't waste your time, there are better books in the sea. First trilogy I'm gonna talk about is the, whoop, not that one. Dream a Little Dream by Kristen Geer. Now she wrote the Ruby Red books, which I really liked. I liked them, I thought they were fun. I know they were a little problematic, but she probably improved because this is a series she wrote after that one. The second one is called Dream On, and the third one is called Just Dreaming. And these are beautiful books, on top of the fact that they sound interesting. So this is about a girl who has some really vivid dreams, and she's dreaming about like people in real life. And then the people in real life start referencing the dream, and then she's like, oh my goodness, is that my dream? Your dream? Were you in my dream? Things like that. It sounds like an intriguing plot, and I think it's something I like, but it's just not something I've heard about on BookTube. The next is a duology, and that is The Prisoner of Night and Fog and Conspiracy of Blood and Smoke, both by Anne Blankman. Now, this is a duology that I think I might have maybe heard about it on BookTube years ago, but I really haven't heard anything. The book covers are just beautiful. Like I wouldn't cry if that was my face. It's beautiful. But I really don't hear much about them. Basically, we are following a girl who I believe is Hitler's niece, and she's been approached by a reporter. Basically, he's informing her of all the crappy things Hitler's doing, and she's like, I didn't know that. So now he wants her to spy on her uncle. It's two books, which tells me she probably doesn't die in the first one. Good news. But I do think I would enjoy them. I generally like World War II historical fiction, and I think they are YA, but sometimes YA and war, they're not as light and fluffy as you might think. So I think they're books that I would really enjoy. I really haven't heard much about them, so if you've read these, tell me. The next series I really haven't heard much from on BookTube is Dune by Carrie Cope and Lori Langdon. Now, the first one, these are also beautiful covers, is Dune. The second one is Destined for Dune, Shades of Dune, and Forever Dune. I mean, they're such pretty covers. I believe these are kind of based on what the movie Brigadoon is, where a girl kind of goes back in time in Scotland or Ireland, I don't remember now, to this, you know, earlier life. And I think she has an option to come back to our current time, and she just has to decide whether she wants to stay back or not. Saying there are four books, I think we also know what her choice is. I haven't heard much about these books. They are time travel, so obviously that interests me right away. And they are beautiful covers, and so maybe they just got an incredible artist and the book is crap, but I really haven't heard much about this. If you've read these, let me know. I want to know. I might just read them even if you hated them, because they just sound interesting. I love the time travel aspect. I love the history that goes into that. It's just so good. The next one I have seen on BookTube some, but only by one BookTuber, and that is Wool by Hugh Howey. This is April Sarah's favorite book in the entire world. That is why it is on my TBR shelf, but I honestly have not heard of any other BookTubers reading this book, this series, or this author. I believe this is made up of five short stories that are kind of based on dystopian society. I think everybody lives in like a silo. There are like certain punishments, so like I think if you're bad, they send you out to like, I don't know, clean the windows or something. It's a little vague, but also it's short stories, so you can't tell too much of a short story. You're gonna give too much away. I have no idea where Wool comes in, but I'm sure it'll make sense once I read it. And the last one I have for you is a trilogy by Mary E. Pearson. Now that name will ring a bell because she wrote Kiss of Deception, which is a trilogy which is super popular on BookTube. But she also wrote The Adoration of Jenna Fox, which is the first book. The second book is The Fox Inherent, and the third book is Forever Fox. Now, these are a trilogy, and actually I like these size. I just don't have all three in this size, but it's a cute little size, and it looks like a pretty quick read too. So this basically follows a girl who wakes up from a coma, and when she wakes up, the life that she's handed isn't the life she has memories from, and she's like really confused because she's like, this is my home. This doesn't ring a bell. I actually have memories of a different home and things along that line. That's all I really know about it, and I think that sounds insanely interesting, and I think I would like this series, but I haven't heard much about it. So please tell me if it's as fantastic as it sounds, or if it's a pile of poo. You can save me a few hours, and I always appreciate that. So those are the top five books series, you know, that I want to read, but I really haven't heard much about from BookTube. So please, please, if you've heard of any of these, tell me down below your thoughts on them. Save me from reading a crappy book, or push me towards reading a great one. Also, check out my other partners in crime, all linked down below. We have Brews and Reviews, Brooke Clark, Christina's Journey, Danny Braxton, and The Story with Serenity Dawn. They are also going to be talking about books that they want to read that they have not found popular on BookTube. Don't forget to like and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll plan on seeing all of you guys tomorrow. Goodbye.